In this video, I want to show you how to install Marlin 2.1.2 into the Artillery Hornet 3D printer. Then you will get linear advance and input shaper in the firmware. I will also show you how to tune input shaper in this video. I have some links in the description. It's for the G-code Marlin documentation and my GitHub, where I have the firmware that I made. There will be a link to download Prontoface and the STM cube tool. I will also show you how to use these tools. Right now I'm doing a test print. I have turned off input shaping and turned off linear advance to just see how the print looks without input shaping turned on. You could do a benchy, a cube. I also printed this ringing tower. We will look at that later to see if we can see some improvements in the print quality. The test cube is now finished. I can try to show you what it looks like. It has some weird artifacts. It was printed at 100 millimeters per second. There is some ringing also, I think. Okay, we will look at that later. Now I want to show you how to install the firmware. To install the firmware, I think it's very useful to have the printer turned on. We will use a cable. Plug it into your computer. To find out which port it's connected to, you go to Device Manager in the settings. This is in Norwegian, but Enhetsbehandling, but in English, I think it's Device Manager. Then you go here to Ports. And the serial USB unit, I think it's the printer, COM4. Then you go to Prontoface. Let me see. If you have Cura or something open, it blocks out the COM ports. I think I have to restart Prontoface. COM4, 250,000 baud rate. Printer is now online. What you do now? You send M997. That puts it in some kind of DFU mode, or it's at least it's possible to upgrade the firmware. Then you go to the STM32 cube programmer, USB connect, and it says here data read successfully. Then you click on this button. It's the download button. Then you go into, I will show you the folder. Marlin 2.1.2, PIO, build, Artillery Ruby. You can use the firmware.bin file, open, and then you click start pro. You can also have verify programming on. Start programming. It's erasing and downloading. Verified successfully. Okay. Okay. So now disconnect this program. Then we go to the prompter face, disconnect. Then you plug out the cable. Turn the printer off. Wait for the screen to die. Then we turn it on. As you can see, Marlin 2.1.2. Okay, so now we need to slice the ringing tower in a special way. If you have Prusa Slicer, I will show you how to do it. So I just made the profile for the Creality Ender 3 printer. And then you just add ringing tower. For this type of printer, Cartesian printer, it's supposed to look like this. And if you go to print settings, if you click on spiralize, it asks you to set some settings. Just click yes. Also on the speed, you should set it high to maybe 100. And acceleration, just set it to 0, so it goes after what the printer has set up. Also, if you go to filament settings and cooling, to untick this auto cooling box, I also set this slowdown if layer print time is below to 0 to be sure that it's not has any problems. So if you go to custom G-code, let me just show you in the link for Marlin documentation, it's the G-code M593. Here you find a lot of information about how to prepare the slicer for the test model. And so in Prusa Slicer, you copy this line, put it in here on the after layer change G-code, then you slice and upload. And now, as I can see, we have this error. Just click reset. As you can see here, I think it's too far away. If you go to configuration, advanced settings, you can see we have the input shaping menu. Now we will print the test model. It takes 1 hour. I will be back when it's finished. Okay, the test print is finished. Let's see if we can see something. It's kind of hard to see, but you can see the ringing and where it might be a little better. This is the Y side. This is the X. It's kind of hard to see in this light. I will try to figure out where it looks the best. Okay, so I'm not sure This is not exactly, but just to show you how it's done. This is, come on. This is, I made a mark where I thought it might look a little better. And then I will show you the input shaping calculator. There are some different ways to do this. You can look at the G codes and you can do some different things, but I found this calculator that TH3D Studio has created. It's in the, you can see it here in the Marlin documentation. If you click on that, you are redirected to this calculator. Then we measure the model. I will do that now. The X is 24.5. The Y was, I think it was 16.5. If you scroll down, this is the values that you put into the firmware. I will show you how to do it in the menu. Okay, so I hope you can see the menu now. We go to configuration, advanced, input shaping. These are the values from the test print. From the calculator, it states x-axis 33.26. So we go to 33.23. And then it's the y, 27.2. Then you go back and store settings. After doing this, you should do the same test print that you had done before to see if we can see any improvements. So I will print that cube now and we will see what it looks like. So the test print is finished. This is the before. It's not. But if we look at the after, I think it looks much better. Just remember that the first one was printed without pressure advance, so that is why the corners are looking so weird. This was printed at 1000 millimeters cubed, 1000 acceleration. It might be a little too high. Maybe I have to turn it down or tune input shaper again. But now you know how to install the firmware and to tune input shaper. I have set the linear advance to 0.3. It should be a little higher, but the Titan extruder makes really loud clicking noise when it's doing the pressure advance, linear advance thing. So I turn it down to 0.3, but if you want to, you can, of course, you're free to tune everything yourself.